Executive performance is nothing more than the sum of productivity and engagement. It's a 2x2. Pete, you know what a 2x2 is? It's this. Show me a failing executive, and I'll show you somebody who doesn't produce results, and the people who assume leadership from them are disengaged. Everybody gets that. There's all kinds of competencies in your organizations. You all have different goals by department, right? There's all sorts of detail, but at the end of the day, when we talk about directors and vice presidents, and we develop them, to what end? Why are we developing a leader? What are we developing them to do? Well, we have a competency model. Well, they gotta get better at this. Well, in our industry, we're like, no. Whatever it is, underneath the P, they gotta be productive. If they don't produce results and their teams don't produce results, bye-bye, in many cases in the private sector. Secondly, they gotta do it through the engagement of humans. If you got humans that don't wanna show up and they're slogged and they're beaten down and they don't have trust and all that toxicity you guys deal with every day, executives are deemed to be unsuccessful. Now there's a 2x2, right? You all know that one. We produce results, but at the cost of, or we have super happy workers at the cost of. Everybody got it? When we do executive development, regardless of your individual competency model, regardless of what McKinsey says, regardless of, at the end of the day, it's how do we help executives produce results in an engaging fashion? Think about leadership performance. Think about executive performance. What else do they gotta do? Behave ethically, okay. That drives engagement. They gotta do a lot of stuff, but it can be summed best in how do we help your leaders produce great results and engage the workforce? One more time, what drives motivation? What will differentiate your culture as you start to compete for talent? Winners like being around winners, high performers like being around high performers, right? Winning locker room, loser locker room sort of mentality. We've got to win and we've got to engage. We've got to help leaders win and engage other humans, not win at the cost of engagement and not engage at the cost of productivity. It's a very, very simple way to think about your organization. That pyramid under the P and the E is that simple. We're going to talk to you about some things we've developed that's all around these two columns. How do we help leaders produce greater results than guys next to them? And how do we help them engage their workforce in creative and nuanced ways differently than other executives? Full stop. Full stop. Full stop. That's what we're trying to do to differentiate and help. Because human resources and recruiters can attract people, and then they come into the organization, and the number one driver of engagement is what? Relationship with boss and peers. So I just got them, and I send them into this dysfunctional, broken leader that we all know is dysfunctional and broken. Yay, we did great. How many of you are shaking your head right now? I just wasted 3 months, I found this controller, this head of IT, this very fancy systems, blah, 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 networking, blah, blah, and we send them into that CIO who you all know is broken. You do this, yes? This is demoralizing for you. You spent 3 months on that search. You spent a couple of dollars, you used the search firm. You did everything right, you had assessment, you got a good candidate. Young up and comer. Boom, punched right in the nose by a toxic or weird or dysfunctional leader. If you're not developing both the acquisition side, the recruiting side, and the development side, you're not winning any war for talent. You're putting them through an existing system that's broken. I argue in this upcycle, we should be spending a ton of money on firms like mine. You like that? We gotta get these leaders, we gotta change their orientation, and talk to them about millennials. Talk to them about women. Talk to them about diversity. Diversity, when some of these baby boomers come into their jobs, they didn't have the diversity they have in today's workforce. Talk about demographic shifts. How am I supposed to deal with that? Most managers and leaders, you know this, are replicators. They're not integrators. Everybody knows what that is, right? Well, this is what I used to do, and I'm just going to twist it one half twist to make it work now. They're trying to constantly fit today's environment into what they learned yesterday. That's a human behavior. So let's not fight it. Let's just help them adjust.